there needs to be more than just tickets, that these real flagrant violators, you know, Pastor Coates sat in jail for a month. So what do we have to do to make sure that we're going after these flagrant violators?
Calgary's mayor and the NDP calling for better enforcement of tickets and fines handed out to those not following the public health orders.
It's incredibly frustrating, and I'm really calling upon the court system and the Crown to take this seriously. They're throwing out far too many tickets, and they shouldn't be doing that because these are flagrant violations of the public health orders.
Naheed Nenshi says that while council is looking at the powers they have around business licenses, he says those are last measures and is first looking to the province for leadership.
I am calling on the province to recognize the seriousness of this, and it's not enough to say, you really should cooperate. It's the law. You have to cooperate.
Meantime, the NDP calling for current fines to be tripled to $3,600 per offense, as well as a more streamlined court process.
We saw thousands of people gather at a rodeo in Bowdoin that was apparently or theoretically designed to intentionally thumb their nose at the law. This event was widely promoted ahead of time. Portions of the event were streamed on the internet, and people reveled in openly flouting public health orders. And yet, the event was allowed to proceed and not a single ticket was issued.
Notley says that AHS is contemplating legal recourse. Meantime, the mayor of Bowdoin says authorities were notified about the no lockdowns rodeo taking place just outside his town.
I actually left a message at the premier's office. I got our MLA and they just said, oh, Alberta Health Services has to deal with it. And then amazingly enough, it went ahead. I just don't understand how.
Almost half of the tickets issued in Alberta relating to public health measures have been withdrawn. The Justice Minister's office says the Alberta Crown Prosecution Service has received a total of 576 tickets between March of last year and the end of March this year. 40% of those tickets have been tossed out. Only 12% have resulted in convictions or fines paid. In Calgary, Tara Overholt, City News.